It's not obvious to me that designation is the correct tool to address
Now, wait just a minute. Designation is what gives the Fed its increased oversight power. Is that correct? Is that correct?
Yes.
And is BlackRock currently designated so that it receives that increased oversight?
It isn't designated, but I think it's important to understand.
So that means it is not receiving the increased oversight from the Fed. So my question is, are you currently looking at designation for companies like BlackRock, $9 trillion companies like this?
Well, as I said, FSOC has looked at this issue in the past.
I understand they've done it in the past. I'm not asking about what the last Secretary of the Treasury did. You are the head of FSOC now. And the question I'm asking is whether or not FSOC is considering and looking at designation for these large financial institutions.
Well, I think it's appropriate to designate institutions whose failure would pose a material risk to U.S. financial
stability. And that's why I started my question with, does potentially a $9 trillion investment company pose some risk to the American economy if it should fail?
Well, one needs to analyze what the risk is. An asset management company is very different than
a bank. How do you analyze what the risk is if you're not actually doing the investigation through FSOC?
Well, FSOC has undertaken such work in the past. And as I said, when it looked at asset managers, it issued a report outlining what it saw as some of the most significant risks
from those industries.
So I
appreciate that
they've
done this in the past. Are you continuing that investigation now?
Well, I'm just beginning a work program with FSOC, and certainly risks from asset management will be on the list.
I understand that when the stock market is going up, it is easy to ignore risks that can be building up in the system. That was the mindset of the regulators that led up to the 2008 crash.